Good morning, one and all. Today we are going to deal with the second lecture of occupational hazards in dentistry. In that first lecture, we have dealt with biological hazards, physical hazards, chemical hazards, and psychological hazards. In the second part, as in the earlier, as we said, ergonomics is considered as one of the type of musculoskeletal disorders. So we are going to deal with the second lecture there. Ergonomics. Ergonomics can be defined as an applied science concerned with designing and arranging things people use so that the people and the things interact most efficiently and safely. The term work-related musculoskeletal disorders refers to which were the work environment that contribute significantly that are made worse long-lasting by working conditions or workplace risk factors. Common examples of such workplace risk factors include jobs requiring repetitive, forceful, or prolonged exertion of the hands, frequent or heavy lifting, pushing or pulling, or carrying of heavy objects, prolonged awkward postures. The level of risk depends on the intensity, frequency, and duration of the exposure to these conditions. Types of musculoskeletal disorders. Musculoskeletal disorders come in a variety of form. The cause of low back pain is often multifactorial, but combined motions of lumbar flexion with rotation increase risk. Furthermore, back pain can exist due to abnormal postures, relative weakness, and then exacerbated with specific injury. Upper back pain. It is not as common as lower back pain. Probably a more frequent cause of mid back pain is muscular pain from the postural muscles and scapular muscles. The contributions of abnormal posture, static postures, poor strength, and overall individual conditioning need to be taken into account. And hand and wrist is one of the type of musculoskeletal disorder. Hand disorders is constant flexion and extension motions of the wrist and fingers. Chronic repetitive movements of the hand and wrist, especially with the hand in pinch position, seems to be the most detrimental problem in hand and wrist musculoskeletal disorder. Other common contributing factors to hand and wrist injuries include working for too long period without allowing rest or alteration of the hand and forearm muscles, mechanical stresses to digital nerves from sustained grasps to sharp objects or instrument handles, forceful work and extended use of vibratory instruments. Especially the vibratory instruments, mostly you will be using the scalars. Some of the common hand and wrist conditions are as follows: tendinitis, decurrens disease, that is tensoitis, trigger finger, carpal tunnel syndrome, and Kyan syndrome. Signs of musculoskeletal disorders. What are the signs we will see in the musculoskeletal disorders? In that, decreased range of motion is one of the conditions we can see as sign. Loss of normal sensation is also a sign. Decreased grip strength and also loss of normal movement is the signs of musculoskeletal disorders. What are the symptoms of musculoskeletal disorders? Excessive fatigue in the shoulders and neck, tingling, burning or other pains in the arms, weak grip and cramping of hands, numbness in fingers and hands, clumsiness and dropping of object. As I said, it becomes a problem of holding the object also within the grip. Hypersensitivity in hands and fingers are the symptoms we can see in the musculoskeletal disorders. What are the dental risk factors? They are awkward postures. More stress is placed on the spinal disc when lifting, lowering, or handling objects with the back bent or twisted compared with when the back is in straight tasks requiring repeated or sustained bending or twisting of the wrist, knees, hips, or shoulders also impose increased stresses on these joints. Activities requiring frequent or prolonged work over the shoulder height can be particularly stressful. Dental personnel assume these awkward postures for the following reasons. Might be all of us will be thinking of the following reasons. It might be to coordinate the relative positions between dentist and the assistant, to obtain optimal view of the teeth within the patient's mouth, to provide a comfortable position for the patient, and to maneuver complex to reach for instruments is one of the things we are being morally thinking of. It might be the following reason of these awkward positions. Forceful exertions. Tasks that require forceful exertions, example are like tooth extractions, place higher loads on the muscles, tendons, ligaments, and joints. Prolonged experiences of this type can give rise to not only feelings of the fatigue, but may also lead to musculoskeletal problem when there is inadequate time for rest or recovery. Force requirements may increase with use of an awkward posture, speeding up of instruments, use of small or narrow tool handles that lessen the grip capacity, use of index finger and thumb to forcefully grip an object, that is a pinch grip compared with gripping the object. These are the force requirements which may increase the musculoskeletal disorders. Duration. Job tasks that require use of same muscles or motions for a long durations increase the likelihood of both localized and general fatigue. In general, the longer the period of continuous work, the longer the recovery or rest time required. Vibration. As I earlier said, exposure to local vibration occurs when a specific part of the body comes in contact with the vibrating object. That the example is when you are holding a scalpel, regarding long holding or long duration of holding the instrument in the vibrating of the scalpel will lead to the carpal tunnel syndrome also. How to do the intervention? Intervention that can be done in the workstation, like proper workstation may include the following. They are dentists or patients chair height, lumbar, thoracic or arm support in the dentist chair, position of instrument table, adequate lighting, edges of work surfaces should be comfortable, having a proper ventilation and pleasant temperature is one of the conditions we can easily reduce the musculoskeletal disorders. Early symptoms in the wrist and hand respond to medical management that include rest, icing or non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs and splints can be the earliest intervention of reducing the musculoskeletal disorders. Early intervention could be important in order to achieve a better result at less cost and inconvenience. Posture. It is one of the interventions we can do. That is, always try to maintain an erect posture, use an adjustable chair with lumbar, thoracic and arm support, minimize excessive wrist movements, avoid excessive finger movements, alternate the work positions between sitting, standing and side of the patient, and also adjust the height of your chair and the patient's chair to a comfortable level. Consider horizontal patient positioning and also check the placement for the adjustable light. In that, clinician should have the back against the seat back, as you see the picture, it should be in the positions like entire backside on the seat and feet flat on the floor, thighs parallel with the floor and the hips slightly higher than knees, shoulders relaxed and parallel with the floor, and eyes directed downwards. That is one of the easiest measure of reducing the musculoskeletal disorders. According to the operator positions, a right hand operator should have these things that should be observed. So if you are in the right front, it should be in the 7 o'clock position as in the clockwise, and if he is in the right at 9 o'clock position, or if he is in the right rear, it should be in the 11 o'clock position, or if he is in the direct rear, it should be in the 12 o'clock position. If the dentist is a left-handed, it should be in the 5 o'clock, 3 o'clock and 1 o'clock position. When working in the four-handed dentistry, it is the easiest and the most efficient method to reduce the musculoskeletal disorders. That is the four-handed dentistry. That is having the dental assistant at the side of the dentist so that the dentist can maintain this position around the operating field with the limited hand, arm and body movement. And it should best confine the eye focus to the working field only. That is, additionally, the dental equipment and the instrument should be centered on the dental assistant so that from the ergonomic point of view, most of the instruments should be over the head or over the patient delivery system, which allows the dental assistants to access the handpieces for burr changes and other operations, or giving the instruments for doing the process. It is the easiest way of reducing the musculoskeletal disorders. In that, one of the components, as I said in the earliest, that is with the biological hazard or the physical hazard or the chemical hazard or psychological hazard. In that also, the gloves. Gloves is one of the things that should be observed in the ergonomical way. They are the dental health worker, like for example, as if a dentist or the dental assistant, should have a proper size and fit of the gloves so that it allows the influence, so that the hands will not get a discomfort, so that we will not lie in the problem of getting the carpal tunnel syndrome. And usage of automatic instruments. As I said, if you are using the automatic instruments, that is to reduce the risk, okay, that is by handing the high speed handpieces, slow speed handpieces, and bell driven drills, lasers, or ultrasonic scalers or endodontic handpieces instead of manual handpieces will reduce the musculoskeletal problems in your fingers or in your shoulders or in the cervical regions also. As we have been dealing with the occupational hazards, it is the most prime concern that OSHA guidelines should be followed throughout the entire world. As if the Occupational Safety and Health Act, which was being formulated by the American Congress in 1970, assures the safe, healthful working conditions for working men or women by setting, enforcing standards by providing training, outreach and education with assistance. This should be followed by every person, that is not only with the dental field, with all other fields also, that is with the Occupational Safety and Health Administration. So by this, we conclude with the chapter of occupational hazards in dentistry. By this, we conclude that occupational health risks are present in every profession. Dentists are one such professional group. In spite of these hazards, we cannot refrain from providing care and serve the community. Sufficient knowledge and adequate information regarding occupational hazards and its prevention will contribute in providing quality care to the patients without any doubts. Dentist has to upgrade his existing knowledge by participating in the continuing dental education programs, and universal precautions should be taken while practicing to prevent the occupational hazards, and dental clinic should be designed with sufficient light, ventilation and engineering control measures and equipped with appropriate personal protective materials. So we conclude with this, the occupational hazards in dentistry. I will show you the musculoskeletal disorders reducing exercises. While doing the process, we should follow some of these types of exercises to reduce the musculoskeletal disorders so that we will be taking care of by ourselves. Push up or mirror positions, like doing as if the exercises you should do, and flickering of wrists is one of the things that should be done after doing the procedures, that is relaxing our fingers or relaxing our palmar fascia so that the carpal tunnel structures or the median nerve should not have the most stressful or cramped, so that we should not face the problem of our fingers, so that we should reduce them by doing the following exercise. Stretch arm strong, that is 2 or 3 repetitions that is recommended every hour, so that we can reduce our shoulder or joint pains, so that we will not be having the stressful conditions of getting the musculoskeletal disorders. Periodic breaks and release of trigger points. Strengthening exercises for back pain and some of the supine position exercises. Hip extension and back stretch positions to reduce the back pains, so these are the following exercises that should be done if you are being relaxed after doing your cases and reduce the musculoskeletal disorder problems. So, thank you for listening to the lecture.